and a beginning. It's warm memories of the past and big dreams of the future.
Graduation day is always a day of rejoicing, for it marks the conclusion of an educational journey and the commencement of another, more uncertain and more difficult part of a student's quest to a better life and future. Truly, today signifies the culmination of many years of hard work in the relentless pursuit of knowledge. Knowledge that will enable a person to embrace opportunities and take on challenges with a clear vision and purpose.
Before we start today's proceedings, we request everyone to maintain silence throughout the ceremony and please switch off your mobile phones.
We thank you all for your cooperation. I now request our beloved Dean and Principal, Dr. V.T. Venkatesha, sir, and our Academic Registrar, Dr. Nandini A.S., to escort our esteemed dignitaries onto the dais.
Seated amongst us today are all the students who have completed their undergraduation, post-graduation, and diplomas. Graduating students, today we are gathered here to recognize your dedication, hard work, effort, and all your achievements in academic, research, scholarship, and teaching.
What better way to begin this prestigious event than with an invocation in the praise of the Lord? Let us immerse ourselves in this prayer, which will be rendered by Lakshmi, a third-year student of our institute.
कामिनी संग दूरने शरणु सांबन प्रीति पुत्रने शरणु जनरिगे मित्रने शरणु शरणु एकदंतने लोक ख्यातने एकवाक्य प्रवीणने एकदंतने लोक ख्यातने एकवाक्य प्रवीणने एक विंशति पत्र पूजित अनेक विनायक एक विंशति पत्र पूजित अनेक विघ्न विनायक चतुर्बाहु चरण तोड़विन चतुरायुध धारने मतिय वंतने मलिन जनितने अतिय मधुराहारने शरणु बेनकने कनक रूपने कामिनी संग दूरने शरणु सांबन प्रीति पुत्रने शरणु जनरिगे मित्रने शरणु 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 शरणु
Thank you for that, Lakshmi.
Hello. Lighting of the lamp is a tradition that has been followed from time immemorial. The lamp leads us from darkness towards light. It burns only to give us the message of peace and light. The presence of Agni or fire ensures success. The flame symbolizes wisdom and knowledge. A lamp teaches you to be upright, rise upwards, and dispel darkness.
Knowledge removes ignorance just as light removes darkness. Knowledge is also a lasting inner wealth by which all outer achievements can be accomplished. Hence we light the lamp to bow down to the knowledge of the greatest wisdom of all form.
Joy.
of recapitulation of past 1 year, celebration of the present, and also filled with curious anticipation of what the future holds. Our forefathers stuck to a very simple motto in their times, Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava. We are duty-bound to welcome the dignitaries, teachers, students, and all of you watching us live today on this grand occasion. Let this be a reminder that without the sacrifices of our parents and teachers, we all would not be sitting here.
We would also like to take this opportunity to welcome all the members of the press who have taken time out to come and capture the memorable moments of this institute. It gives me immense pleasure in welcoming our Dean and Principal, Dr. V.T. Venkatesha. Sir is a forensic expert and has devoted his career towards sincerely serving the institution and its students. He is very supportive and encouraging towards all students, both academically and with respect to all extracurricular activities. It is our pleasure, sir, to welcome you to deliver the welcome address.
ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಒನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಡಿಗ್ನಿಟರೀಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಡಯಾಸ್, ಫ್ಯಾಕಲ್ಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಕಿಮ್ಸ್, ಗೆಸ್ಟ್, ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿಜುವಲ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಐ ಫೀಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಿವಿಲೇಜ್ ಟು ಡಿಲಿವರ್ ದ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಅಕೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರಾಜುಯೇಷನ್ ಡೇ. ದಿಸ್ ಡೇ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಮೆಮೊರೇಬಲ್ ಇವೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎವರಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆನರ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವಿತ್ ಅಸ್ ಟುಡೇ ಅವರ್ ಎಸ್ಟೀಮ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕೆ ಸುಧಾಕರ್, ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ Health and Family Welfare and Minister for Medical Education, Government of Karnataka. Dr. K. Sudhakar was born in a little village called Perisandra in Chikbalapur district on 6th June of 1973. Inspired by his grandfather, Sri Patel Avala Reddy, Dr. Sudhakar developed the passion for serving the society at a very early age. After obtaining his medical degree, Dr. Sudhakar dedicated his time and effort on service to the society, as he strongly believed that he can reach larger section of the society through social service to create a healthy society and a healthy nation. Dr. Sudhakar was elected as a member of Karnataka Legislative Assembly from Chikbalapura constituency in the year of 2013 and 2018. He was also re-elected to the assembly again in 2019. As you are aware, the year of 2000 was a difficult period for everyone due to COVID-19 pandemic. The state of Karnataka, under the able leadership of our honorable minister, succeeded in controlling the pandemic effectively and received the appreciation from all sections of the society. He's a strong environmentalist and is always in the forefront in fight against pollution. He's a strong advocate for a greener tomorrow and has promoted various eco-friendly projects across the state. Sudhakar is the main force behind the setting up of 943 crore Ebbal Nagavara project, which will bring scientifically treated water to 44 irrigation tanks of Chikbalapur district. He is also working reviving 330 acre of Kandavara tank, which helps reduce the farmers' dependency on rainwater for farming. He is also in the forefront of promoting ecotourism in Nandi Hills. His vision is to ensure a sustainable environment for future generations. His mission is to reduce carbon footprint in the state of Karnataka. He also visualizes making Karnataka a model state in reducing pollution and enforcing environmental friendly legislations. On behalf of Raja Vakkaligara Sangha and Kempegowda Institute of Medical Sciences, I extend a hearty welcome to you, sir. I would like to welcome our ever supporting and dynamic administrator of Raja Vakkaligara Sangha, Sri M.K. Shankar Lingegowda, retired IAS, who is instrumental in reviving the past glory of our institutions. I am pleased to welcome our beloved CEO of Raja Vakkaligara Sangha, Sri S. Shankar Narayan, retired IAS, whose selfless service has helped in the overall development and progress of our institutions. I welcome the HODs and faculties of KIMS who have played a major role in training our young graduates. I extend my Hearty welcome to my beloved students who have completed their graduation and post-graduation successfully and are ready to serve the mankind. Thank you very much, and I hope all of you will have a memorable day ahead.
Thank you, sir, for those wonderful words. Kindly accept a token of our appreciation.
Moving on, I would like to call upon our beloved academic register, Dr. Nandini A.S. Ma'am, who has played a pivotal role in the success of the academic events that have taken place in our college since she took the charge of this responsibility. Ma'am, it's an honor to welcome you today to deliver the academic report for the year 2020-21.
As the academic register of... It is my proud privilege to present the academic report of this prestigious institution for the academic year 2021. Coming to the undergraduate results, in 2019, the batch of 2018 took the Phase 1 MBBS examination. 81.7% of this batch aced the staff exam with 70 first classes. 21 students did the institution proud by securing distinction, with the highest being 82.2%. The batch of 2017 took the Phase 2 MBBS exams. We had a pass percentage of 67.2% with 42 first classes and 11 distinctions. The batch of 2016, who took the Phase 3 Part 1 MBBS exams, achieved a 75% pass percentage with 73 first classes and 1 distinction. The batch of 2015 is the graduating batch this year. They took the Phase 3 Part 2 exams in December 2019 and achieved a 74% pass percentage with 36 first classes. Owing to the COVID pandemic, the UG exams of 2020 have been postponed and are scheduled to take place over the next 2 months this year. In the graduating batch, 9 students bagged 19 university ranks. The following were the university ranks bagged by KIMS. Dr. Likhet B.K. secured rank 4 in anatomy, 8 in biochemistry, 6 in pathology, and 7 in forensic medicine. He also secured rank 8 in phase 1 exams and rank 8 in phase 2 exams. Dr. Aishwarya G. Shinde secured rank 5 in pharmacology, 6 in anatomy, and rank 10 in biochemistry. She also secured rank 10 in phase 1 exams. Dr. Vikyat Satish secured rank 9 in pathology and rank 10 in biochemistry. Dr. Shilpa S. secured rank 10 in biochemistry and rank 10 in forensic medicine. Dr. Meghna S. Kakarla secured rank 8 in forensic medicine. Dr. Anandini Pal got rank 10 in ophthalmology. Dr. Sucheta Sanjeev Chikodi got rank 5 in biochemistry. Dr. Amulya Murthy, rank 9 in ophthalmology. Dr. Sharavi Budanur got rank 5 in general surgery. This graduating batch are all-rounders with representation in national-level quiz competitions, athletic meets, and conferences. They organized the annual sports meet in year 2018. When the graduating batch was in the third year, that is 2018, an international conference called KIMS Model WHO was conducted based on the Model UN, which was conducted at world-class universities such as Harvard, Yale, and Oxford universities. This was conducted as a simulation of World Health Assembly proceedings for the first time in India in 2016 in our college. So the graduating batch took this forward and successfully conducted the third edition of this event. Dr. Ramya Shree has won the second place in surgery poster presentation in Empower 2018 at Chennai. Dr. Vikyat Satish won first prize in medical case report competition and on World Health Day 2017 and second place in UG quiz conducted by BSOG in 2019. His paper on incidence on chronic spontaneous urticaria and dental infections was published in an international journal. His research on spectrum of nephrotic syndrome in adults is also published. Dr. Rakshit P. Uttam has a publication on phenotypic detection of colistin resistance among clinical isolates of carbapenemase producing gram-negative bacilli. Under the guidance of Faculty of Department of Community Medicine, there were two publications. One by Dr. Anandini Pal on correlation of personality and mental well-being with Facebook use and its relation with gender. The other one was by Dr. G. Bharat on traffic health among commuters in urban Bangalore. Dr. Amulya Murthy, Dr. Anantini Pal, Dr. Bharatji, and Dr. Aditi Neelakantan have ICMR certified research product, research papers, and grants to their credit. Dr. Likith has secured highest in Phase 1, Phase 2, and Phase 3, Part 2. Dr. Amulya Murthy secured highest marks in Phase 3, Part 1 exams. Dr. Shriya Rajshekar, being the class representative, has worked hard to coordinate the schedule for their batch throughout the course with a special mention during COVID pandemic. Coming to the postgraduate results, during 2020, the batch of 2017 took their postgraduate degree exams and the batch of 2018 took their postgraduate diploma exams. We have had 100% pass percentage in majority of the specialities. In the postgraduate exams, 8 students bagged university ranks. Following are the RGUHS rank holders. Dr. Preeti R. Gandhi secured rank 9 in MD General Medicine. Dr. Neetu Kumari secured second rank in MD Community Medicine. Dr. R. Tenambigai secured 8th rank in MD Community Medicine. Dr. Vijay Kumar S. secured 2nd rank in MD Emergency Medicine. Dr. Tara Rachel Paul secured 6th rank in MS Otorhinolaryngology. Dr. Sarthak Kamath K. secured 8th rank in MD Psychiatry. Dr. Prateek Agarwal secured rank 4 in DMRD Radiodiagnosis. Dr. Meghana Tota secured rank 2 in DLO exams. So we are proud to say that KIMS has bagged a total of 27 university ranks. The postgraduates too are all-rounders. Dr. Sarthak Kamath from Psychiatry won second prize in PG quiz in 2019 and second prize in Neuroradiology quiz in 2018. He is also a TED Talk speaker and has spoken in 2 international muscular dystrophy conferences as a psychiatrist. He is also the first person with Duchenne's muscular dystrophy in the whole world to complete his MD degree. Dr. Gururaj V. Gunda from General Medicine won the first prize in the PG quiz in 2018 and first prize in case presentation in API. Dr. Taruni Lata and Dr. Hilas Saliha from General Medicine won best poster presentation in Epicon 2019 at Kochi. Dr. Ankit P. Bhujani and Dr. Preeti R. Gandhi from General Medicine won best paper presentation in Capricorn 2019 in Belgavi. Dr. Ajay Babu from Pulmonary Medicine won first prize in state level PG quiz in 2020, first prize in interactive case discussion in ICS talent search in 2018, and second prize in state level quiz in 2019. Dr. Prajwal from Surgery won first and second prize in poster presentation in ESICON 2019. Dr. Meghna Tota and Dr. Natasha from ENT presented posters and papers at AICON 2019. Dr. Anita from Dermatology won first prize in state level IADL PG quiz, first place in TISA zonal round South Zone, second prize in ISPD and second prize in Dermatorheumatology quiz by BDS. She has published a case report on systematized varicose epidermal levers. Dr. Chaitra from Dermatology has won second prize in zonal round in TISA quiz and was selected for national round Ahmedabad. She has participated in national round in TISA, presented a case in Derm India 2019, won second prize for e-poster in QTCon 2019 and presented award paper in Dermacon 2019 at Pune. Dr. Kalpashri from Dermatology has won second prize in ISPD National Quiz, first prize in IADL State Quiz, second prize in BDS Dermatorheumatology Quiz. She has participated in IADL State Award paper presentation in 2018-2019 and IADL National Free Paper presentation in 2019 and IADL National Award paper in 2020. She has published Incidence of Chronic Spontaneous Urticaria in Dental Infection in International Journal. Dr. Neeta George from OBG has won third prize for her poster presentation. Dr. Afraz Jahan from Community Medicine won the best oral paper presentation at CatchCon. Dr. Tenambigai from Community Medicine won the best oral presentation in IAACon. I am also proud to announce that many of our past alumni have fared well in the NEET PG 2020 and are going to join their dream branches in the coming days through the due process. I am happy to announce that Shashikala, librarian at KIMS, completed her PhD in 2020. It is an honor for me to announce that the faculty of our Department of Community Medicine were external monitors in evaluation of Mission Indradhanush and intensified pulse polio immunization. Last but not the least, I would like to appreciate the graduating interns and postgraduates for their efforts, dedication, and relentless work during COVID pandemic. Many of them tested positive but continued working once they recovered. My special appreciation to the parents of these graduates who stood by their side through these tough times. As the academic registrar, I am proud to announce these achievements and I'm optimistic that there'll be many more academic achievements in the convocations to come. Wishing all the graduates and postgraduates all the very best and thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Kindly accept a token of our appreciation. As we know, an oath is a solemn promise about your behavior or actions. Often, we take an oath, the promise invokes a divine being. Graduates, as you begin your duty towards society as doctors, do take a moment to follow the steps of those who have embarked on this journey before you by taking the Hippocratic Oath.
I now request all the graduates to stand up for the oath. I also request our beloved Dr. Shubha Ma'am, Professor of Anatomy at KIMS Bengaluru, to administer the oath to our graduates.
Graduates, please raise your right hand in front of you and repeat after me. I solemnly pledge myself to consecrate my life to the service of humanity. I will practice my profession with conscience and dignity. The health of my patient will be my first consideration. I will respect the secrets which are confided in me. I will maintain by all the means in my power the honor and the noble tradition of the medical profession. My colleagues will be my brothers. I will not permit consideration of religion, nationality, race, party, politics, or social standing to intervene between my duty and my patient. I will maintain the utmost respect for human life from the time of conception, even under threat. I will not use my medical knowledge contrary to the laws of humanity. I make these promises solemnly, freely, and upon my honor. Thank you. Please be seated.
Thank you, ma'am. The will to win, the desire to succeed, the urge to reach your full potential, these are the keys that will unlock the door to personal excellence. Amongst us today are a few individuals who went the extra mile and who must most definitely be acknowledged and appreciated for the same. We would now like to call upon our esteemed chief guest, Dr. K. Sudhakar, to give away the certificates to our award winners.
Dr. Likit B.K. He is the recipient of Srimati Sarojamma Iregowda Memorial Gold Medal for securing the highest marks in MBBS Phase 3 Part 2 examinations. Dr. Adeep S. Narayana Memorial Award for the highest marks in MBBS Phase 2. He is also the recipient of Professor C. Whittle Golden Independence Commemorative Award. He has secured a university rank of 4 in anatomy, 8 in biochemistry, 6 in pathology, 7 in forensic medicine. He has also secured a university rank of 8 in phase 1 examinations and a university rank of 8 in the phase 2 exams. He has also secured the highest marks in anatomy, pathology and forensic medicine. Dr. Likhit DK.
Dr. Amulya Murthy, she is the recipient of the Dr. Sudhakar's Physiology Excellence Award for securing the highest marks in physiology. She has also secured the highest marks in ophthalmology with a university rank of 9 for the same. She has also secured the highest marks in the Phase 3 Part 1 examinations.
Dr. Sucheta Chikodi secured the highest marks in biochemistry in the RGHS examinations and has also secured a 5th rank in the university for the same. Dr. Sucheta Chikodi.
Dr. Aishwarya G. Shinde has secured the highest marks in pharmacology with a university rank of 5 for the same. She has also got a rank 6 in anatomy and rank 10 in biochemistry. She has also secured a rank 10 in the phase 1 examinations.
Dr. Sindhu C. has secured the highest marks in otorhinolaryngology. Dr. Neeti Srinivas, she has won the KIMS Community Medicine Award for securing the highest marks in community medicine in the RGHS examinations.
Dr. Mithali Zakarias is the recipient of the Kumari Suma Jayaram Memorial Endowment Prize and Dr. R. Srinivas Memorial Gold Medal for securing the highest marks in general medicine.
Dr. Sharvi Budhanur, she is the recipient of the Karyappa Memorial Award for securing the highest marks in general surgery. She has also won a university rank of 5 for the same.
Dr. Kirtiga M. is the recipient of the Sri B. J. Linge Gowda Memorial Gold Medal for securing the highest marks in obstetrics and gynecology.
Dr. Shilpa S. has won the Sri Malur Puttaswamy Gowda or the Chude Gowda Memorial Gold Medal for securing the highest marks in pediatrics. She has also secured a university rank of 10 in biochemistry and rank 10 in forensic medicine.
Dr. Ankit S. Nair, he is the recipient of the Cultural Excellence Award for the year 2020.
Dr. Ashish Barua is the winner of the Sports Excellence Award.
Dr. Rakshit P. Uttam is the recipient of the Sri K. Singri Gowda Memorial Award for the Best Outgoing Student of the Year for the Batch 2015. He has also secured the highest marks in microbiology and has won the Dr. Sitaram Reddy Memorial Award for the same.
Next are the RGHS rank holders. Dr. Vikyat Satish, rank 9 in pathology and rank 10 in biochemistry.
Dr. Meghna S. Kakarla has secured a rank 8 in forensic medicine.
Dr. Anantini Pal has secured a rank 10 in ophthalmology.
Next, we move on to the postgraduate awards. Dr. Preeti R. Gandhi is the recipient of the Srimati Lakshmamma Channaiya Memorial Gold Medal for securing the highest marks in MD General Medicine. She has also secured a university rank of 9.
Dr. Gagan Satyaprakash is the winner of the Sri C. Balagopalam Memorial Gold Medal for securing the highest marks in MS General Surgery.
Dr. Viveta Elango is the recipient of the Sri Nara Shailaja Pratap Reddy Academic Excellence Award Memorial for securing the highest marks in MD Pediatrics.
Dr. Kalpashri, she is the winner of Dr. Sri Sharat Kumar BC Academic Excellence Award in Dermatology for securing the highest marks in MD Dermatology.
Next, moving on to the RGHS University rank holders. Dr. Neetu Kumari secured the second rank in MD Community Medicine. Dr. R. Tenambigai secured the 8th rank in MD Community Medicine.
Dr. Vijay Kumar S. has secured the 2nd rank in MD Emergency Medicine. Dr. Tara Rachel Paul has secured the 6th rank in MS Otorhinolaryngology. Dr. Prateek Agarwal has secured rank 4 in DMRD radio diagnosis.
Dr. Meghna Tota has secured the 2nd rank in Diploma Otorhinolaryngology.
It's our honor to call upon Dr. Sarthak Kamath K, who has secured the 8th rank in MD Psychiatry and is the first person with Duchenne's muscular dystrophy in the whole world to complete his MD degree. Give him a huge round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Can we please have a standing ovation for him, please? Thank you, everyone. You may please be seated.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Now we request M.K. Shankar Lingegowda, sir, our administrator of the Rajya Vakkaligar Sangha, to confer the degree certificates to the MBBS graduates.
Dr. A. Harshita.
Aban Ulhaq.
Dr. Abdul Rakib Sheikh, Dr. Abhilasha S. Dr. Adarsh S. Gowda. Dr. Aditi Neelakantan. Dr. Amir Zain. Dr. Aishwarya Sanjay Hada. Dr. Akshay MD. Dr. Amal Matthew. Dr. Amin Aftab.
Dr. Anjali Arvind. Dr. Anshida. Dr. Anusha N. Dr. Anushka Agarwal. Dr. Arya K. Ramesh. Dr. Ashina B. Munir. Dr. Ashmi Samad. Dr. Ashwin Kumar. Dr. Ashwini Kashi. Dr. Athira Balasubramanian.
Dr. Athira S. Warrior. Dr. Atma Nair R. Dr. Atulya K. Narayanan. Dr. Bharat Gairola. Dr. Bharat Gajendran. Dr. Bharat Jairam. Dr. Binil Raj B. Dr. Dennis Cherian. Dr. Devi Raj K. Dr. Devika Anil Kumar.
Dr. Devika K. Das. Dr. Dheeraj K. Dr. Donna Joseph. Dr. Garvit Jain. Dr. Gautam S. Dr. Gayatri Mohan. Dr. Gokul Manoj. Dr. Gokul Srinath. Dr. Gopika KM. Dr. Gopikrishnan VV.
Thank you, sir. We now request Sri S. Shankar Narayana, CEO of the Raja Vokalirigal Sangha, to confer the next set of certificates. Dr. Gauri PM. Dr. Grishma EG. Dr. Grishma VR. Dr. Haneen S. Dr. Hari Krishna S. Dr. Harsha AG. Dr. Harshita Nagraj. Dr. Hasmita Venu. Dr. Hema M. Dr. Hemant Kumar SM. Dr. Irfan Rashid.
Dr. Janavi and Swami. Dr. Jishnuraj N. Dr. Jumana Jamal. Dr. K. Renuka. Dr. Kavyashri R. Dr. Kavya Upendran. Dr. Kirtana S. Gowda. Dr. Kenza. Dr. Kiran P. Dr. Kiritana.
Dr. Kishore Raj. Dr. Lavina S. Dr. Lekhashri R. Dr. Lakshmi Krishna L. Dr. Nishchal M. Dr. M. Sharmila. Dr. Madhura VC, Dr. Mahalakshmi M, Dr. Manya R. Shekhar, Dr. Marina Ponnachan, Dr. Mayank Lunawat, Dr. Mustafa, Dr. Mohan Raj RK,
Dr. Nagashri S. Holla, Dr. Nakul Krishnan, Dr. Namita K, Dr. Navya C, Dr. Neeraj Sanjeev, Dr. Nidhi Partha, Dr. Nikhil, Dr. Nikita Jaigopal, Dr. Niranjana K, Dr. Nivedita S. Naik, Dr. Nivedita C, Dr. Abhay Patil.
Thank you, sir. I now request our Dean and Principal, Dr. V.T. Venkatesha, to confer the next set of certificates. Dr. Pooja G, Dr. Poojita G.P., Dr. Prajwal Atreya, Dr. Preeti R.T., Dr. Radhika M., Dr. Ramya Shri, Dr. Revati Nair, Dr. Rohan H.P., Dr. Pradeepa Shekhar, Dr. Sahana Desai, Dr. Sahana Desai, Dr. Sanjana Hebbar, Dr. Sanviti Anjanappa,
Dr. Sayan P. Ghosh, Dr. Celia Smith, Dr. Shahuraj Patil, Dr. Shanta Gowda, Dr. Sharanya Chanapa, Dr. Shilpa K. Nayak, Dr. Shreya Bhatt, Dr. Shriya Rajshekar, Dr. Shweta M. Patil, Dr. Sindhu V, Dr. Sinduja R, Dr. Sneha Begum, Dr. Soumya Matthew, Dr. Soundarya J, Dr. Shruti V. Nair,
Dr. Sumit Suresh, Dr. Supriya, Dr. Surya C, Dr. Tejas Kumar JK, Dr. Tejaswini CM, Dr. Vaishak J. Gowda, Dr. Vaishali Gupta, Dr. Vandana BD, Dr. Varun NS, Dr. Vidula S, Dr. Vignesh K.R. Madhu, Dr. Vismita Vishwanath, Dr. Vivek Sharma, Dr. Yogita Kadam, Dr. Harshit P. Gowda, thank you, sir. And now request our academic registrar, Dr. Nandini Ma'am, to confer the next set of certificates.
Dr. Yukti HN, Dr. Suprajit Mahesh, Dr. Priya R, Dr. Rahul M. Dr. Suhas Chandragowda. Dr. Chirashwini Venugopal. Dr. Vishal RM. Dr. Abhijit. Dr. Ankita Argauda. Dr. Chandana DK. Dr. Divyashri. Dr. Pragat Janardhan. Dr. Rahul Taylor. Dr. Sharana Basappa. Dr. Syed Mohammed Tayeb Raza.
Dr. Srinidhi MS. Dr. Tejas S. Dr. Yashpal Singh Rajpurohit. Dr. Kanhaiya Kumar Jha. Dr. Nisarga Jagdish. Dr. Adil Akhtar. Dr. Nishant Gaurav. Dr. Prabhat Kumar. Dr. Zulantham Joseph. Dr. Rakshit RB. Dr. Shishti. Thank you, ma'am. We now request our chief guest for the day to present the PG certificates.
Dr. Leah Said Sheikh, MD Pharmacology. Dr. Sneha Motwani, MD Pathology. Dr. Sanchit Singhal, MD Pathology. Dr. Saubhagya K, MD Community Medicine. Dr. Taruni Lata, MD General Medicine. Dr. Gururaj Vigunda, MD General Medicine. Kirtiraj A, MD General Medicine. Dr. Harish TJ, MD General Medicine. Dr. Hilas, MD General Medicine. Dr. Anjum Ara, MD Pediatrics. Dr. Nannapaneni Meghana, MD Pediatrics. Dr. Anita, MD Dermatology. Dr. Chaitra T, MD Dermatology. Dr. Ankit Pandey, MD Respiratory Medicine.
Dr. Ajay Babu, MD Respiratory Medicine. Dr. Vidyashri, MS General Surgery. Dr. Ganesh Kumar R, MS General Surgery. Dr. Syed Abdul, MS Orthopedics. Dr. Amit Kamath, MS Orthopedics. Thank you, sir. We now request Sri M.K. Shankarlinge Gowda, sir, to confer the rest of the certificates. Dr. Dhatri Suresh, MS Obstetrics and Gynecology. Dr. Anushree S, MS OBG. Dr. Shweta Ghosh, MS OBG. Dr. Neeta G, MS OBG. Dr. Sushma, MS OBG. Dr. Lavanya Chetan, MD Anesthesia. Dr. Prajit RS, MD Anesthesia. Dr. Amulya N, MD Anesthesia. Dr. Anish Rajan, MD Anesthesia. Dr. Chinmaya S, MD Radiology. Dr. Meeraj, MD Radiology. Dr. Aishwarya, Diploma in Obstetrics and Gynecology. Dr. Avinash Agarwal, Diploma in Child Healthcare. Dr. Akash BK, Diploma in Child Healthcare. Dr. C.K. Samina, Diploma in Anesthesia.
Dr. Kalpashri, MD Dermatology.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. A hearty congratulations to all our graduates. Let's have a huge round of applause for all our graduates. Gracing the occasion today, we have our esteemed chief guest, Dr. K. Sudhakar, to address our young doctors. Sir, I request you.
Shri M.K. Shankarlinga Gowdaji, Administrator, Rajya Vakkaligala Sangha. CEO of the Rajya Vakkaligala Sangha, Shri S. Shankar Narayan Dore. Dean and Principal, Dr. V.T. Venkatesh. Academic Registrar, Dr. Nandini A.S. And all the professors, associate professors, assistant professors, lecturers, all the academic wing of academic wing, nursing, paramedical staff, my dear doctors, postgraduates, and all the proud parents who have assembled here. ತಮ್ಗೆಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಹಾರ್ದಿಕ ಶುಭಾಶಯಗಳನ್ನು ಮೊದಲು ನಾನು ಕೋರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಯಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಕಳೆದ 5 ವರ್ಷ, ಸುಮಾರು 5.5 ವರ್ಷದ ಹಿಂದೆ ಬಹಳ ಕನಸುಗಳನ್ನು ಕಟ್ಕೊಂಡು, ನಿಮಗಿನ್ನ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಕನಸುಗಳು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪೋಷಕರು ಕಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು, ಅವರ ಕನಸನ್ನು ನನಸು ಮಾಡಿದಿರಿ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕನಸನ್ನು ನನಸು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ. ಇವತ್ತು ನಿಜವಾದಂಥ ಪ್ರಪಂಚಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾಲಿಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ. ಒಬ್ಬ ಪರಿಪೂರ್ಣವಾದಂಥ ವೈದ್ಯರಾಗಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಜಗತ್ತಿಗೆ ಕಾಲನ್ನು ಇಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ. ಭಾಳ ಹೊರ ರಾಜ್ಯಗಳಿಂದ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಪೋಷಕರಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಬರೀ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತನಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು ಸಾಧು ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಯಂಗ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇಂಡೀಡ್ ಪ್ರಿವಿಲೇಜ್ಡ್ ಟು ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಗಸ್ಟ್ ಗ್ಯಾದರಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಓವರ್ ದ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಮೆರಿಟೋರಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವೆರಿ ಪ್ರೆಸ್ಟೀಜಿಯಸ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್, ಕೆಂಪೇಗೌಡ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸಸ್. This institution is almost 40 years old institution, which is located in the heart of Bangalore, and it is named after a legendary character of Karnataka, Shri Kempegowda, who was a great administrator, warrior, and a reformer. So I think it is a great privilege for all the students who have studied in this great institution. Today, you have not just fulfilled your desires, dreams. Today, you have fulfilled the dreams and aspirations of your parents. So they are, today, their day is blissful day. Today, I was seeing many students in their eyes, it was sparkling with pride and joy. This pride should remain in the future life of yours. It's a long journey. Many of you, about 150 students, today have become doctors, graduates. About 111 in this batch, I think they have become postgraduates. Even the postgraduate students, they have not completed the academics because our profession is a very long one. It's a very long journey. Today, even in the remote villages, if somebody wants to come to a doctor, he would like to read the number of degrees after our names. So those were the days even RMP doctors were able to treat many issues. But today, MBBS, post-graduation, super specialization, and lot more fellowships in various foreign universities are expected by even a common man of the India. So this is a new challenge. So this should be your new vision. This is a competitive world, and we need to be prepared for that competition. So my dear friends, today in the 21st century, many worlds, many countries are fighting for geographies. Ours is the only profession, it's called the noblest profession in the world. We do not know the world what is enmity is, but we should all know empathy and sympathy. This should be the strongest feature of a doctor. Healthcare was never challenged till the COVID times have come. All other departments were exposed to various kinds of challenges. Today is also a day which I am completing 1 year in office, medical education. This is exactly 1 year back, 6th February 2020, I became a medical education minister. So exactly on the March 8th, we witnessed the first COVID patient in Karnataka. So from then till today, I am having a huge challenge to address the COVID issue in Karnataka. So in the process, we have built a huge healthcare infrastructure in Karnataka. I am very happy Kempegowda Institute of Medical Sciences, this institution, took the issue of COVID very seriously. Hence, they treated many, many patients. You also established a state-of-the-art virology lab, RT-PCR lab, genomic lab. And today, we also witnessed, we inaugurated a 13-kL oxygen plant, which was the need of the hour today. As we all know, the COVID patients, primarily their saturation levels were down. So the first line of treatment is providing them with adequate oxygen. So this institution, I really admire, I acknowledge from the government's point of view, we really, you all cooperated and supported the government in the need of the hour. So I really acknowledge the administration. I have been noticing this institution in the last 20-25 years. But never I have seen such a proactive administrative team under the leadership as now Sri Shankarlinga Gowda ji. He has served in many capacities in the government. Also, he was a secretary, principal secretary for the medical education. Similarly, our Sri Shankar Narayan ji also happens to be from the undivided district of mine, Kolar. So, along with them, Dr. V.T. Venkatesh, who is extremely proactive and taking this institution progressively in the interest of students academically in every facet of the medical education that it is required. So today, medical education needs the utmost attention of not just the governments and also the society and the students. As I told you earlier, learning never ends, especially for a doctor. And today, learning has to be a continuous process. That is why we want to introduce the best academic curriculum under the RGUHS University. You are affiliated to the Rajiv Gandhi Health University, the single university, health university in Karnataka, which has to monitor almost more than 60 medical colleges in the state. We are proud to say Karnataka has the most number of medical colleges in the entire country. We have close to 64 medical colleges. We have 17 fully functioning government medical colleges. And this year, we started 4 new medical colleges in 4 new districts: Chikbalapur, Chikmagalur, Yadgir, and Haveri districts. Similarly, we inaugurated in the last year, in the December, one new medical college under Vajpayee, Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee Medical College, again in the heart of Bangalore, Shivajinagar. We are trying to build a robust health infrastructure in Karnataka. As we all know, the healthcare in Karnataka has always been prioritized. And today, to many countries, especially to African continent, Bangalore still remains a favorite healthcare destination. So we call it a health tourism. So today it is a favorite destination for many African countries because of the quality of the healthcare professionals that we have in Bangalore and Karnataka. Institutions like, private institutions like Narayana Hrudayalaya, Manipal, Aster, we have some world-class private establishments set up in Bangalore. As a minister, my concern always has been to address the healthcare facility in the rural areas. We all know that about less than 1/3 of the people reside in urban areas, in the cities. But still more than 2/3 or more than 70% of the people reside in rural areas. Today, according to WHO, the beds to the patient ratio should be 2.7 to 1,000. But unfortunately, in Karnataka, we have 1.1 to 1,000 population. Similarly, various parameters says our doctors ratio to population, again it is less than the WHO requirement. According to WHO, we need to have more than 10 to 11 doctors for every 1,000 population. But we are still lagging behind. We have only 3 to 4 doctors. Though after Narendra Modi ji has become the Prime Minister, since 2014, in the last 6 years, he has expanded the medical education by multifold. He has increased 158 medical colleges in the country in the last 6 years. So this is a great achievement by any government. Similarly, today we have more than 50,000 seats which has been increased in the last 6 years under graduation. Similarly, the post-graduation seats have been increased. Today, we are speaking only about the quality of the infrastructure, the quality of the medical education, the needs of the medical education, the tie-up. But what about the intent of the medical doctor? How do we change his intent? So that is why in 21st century, in 2021, I would like to give a call from the government. Our young doctors should dedicate themselves at least a couple of years to serve in the rural areas. This should be your dream. This should be your new passion. That is why in the last year, I have come out with a plan. Whoever studies in Karnataka, be it in deemed universities, government facilities, or the private establishments, every postgraduate or a graduate, after their completion of their course, they should serve the rural areas of Karnataka minimum 1 year. This we have already started implementing this in this year. There are close to 280 postgraduates, doctors, who are already serving in our health systems, in district headquarters, taluk hospitals. We all know healthcare in India, it is scattered in three phases or three departments: primary healthcare, secondary healthcare, and tertiary healthcare. All tertiary healthcare is predominantly in district headquarters. Essentially, it is in district headquarters and metropolitan cities like Bangalore or corporation, Mangalore, Kalburgi, Belagam, Hubli. So, our Chief Minister, Shri B.S. Yediyurappa ji, is very committed. He has already told me to improve the health infrastructure in rural areas. So we have a new plan of establishing, modernizing the primary health care. Our primary health centers today, we have only one allopathic doctor who is a graduate. From this year, we have a proposal to make every private, the primary health center as a 24/7 center with two allopathic doctors and one Ayush doctor in place. From 6 beds to where we would like to increase it to 12 beds in rural areas. Because we have witnessed those people who need to take care, those people who need to be treated in private or the primary health centers, they end up in the tertiary health centers, which is a district, large district hospitals. Our OPDs are in thousands in the district hospitals, where they could have been easily treated in PHCs and CHCs and taluk hospitals. So, we are designing in such a way that Karnataka's healthcare system in the coming days will be a model in the entire country. So we are trying to tie all the loose ends that we have had in the past. Similarly, our emergency ambulance services, we are trying to add 10 to 12 services, and we would like to come out with the robust emergency health services, which includes even the air ambulances. We need to increase the trauma centers. We need to make every tertiary facility in the districts a comprehensive tertiary health hospitals. That center should be able to treat all the issues related to cardiology, nephro-urology, dermatology, cancer. As we all know, NCDs are on the rise today. That is the second largest reason for the fatalities, mortality today. And similarly, mother and child hospitals we would like to increase. This year we would like to establish 125 hospitals in the state. So my dear friends, lot of graduates today, 150 graduates are added to the system today. 111 postgraduates you are added to the society today. Society is strengthened by so many doctors. So we really acknowledge, we want all of you to go out and take the challenges. I'm sure once you have selected this profession, you are dedicated, there is no doubt. You have taken the Hippocrates oath today. For you, only the patient matters. No matter what, which religion he belongs to, which nation he belongs to, this is not the matter of consideration. So you have taken the oath, you must be above board. And I always appeal to the young doctors, studying in abroad is not a crime, is not illegal. But please study, go for your higher studies, get new skills, learn new skills. Without skills, today it is very difficult to survive. But please come back and serve your brothers and sisters of this great nation. Because this nation has given you the platform, has given you the new platform. This nation has made you a responsible citizen today. So please serve those people who are in need in this country. I have observed in many, many areas, various other fields, the best talents are being exported to the countries, US, be it Europe or Japan or Australia. So, my humble appeal for all the doctors to stay back in this nation to serve your own countrymen. And the commitment and the dedication should be so much in this profession, there would be no time for you to think about yourself. I remember of a small story about Isaac Newton. We all know who Isaac Newton was. From Switzerland, he goes on to attend a conference in France. His wife packs for 2-3 days his clothes and sends him in a nice small briefcase. He goes back, he attends the conference, comes back, returns back to the home. And when his wife sees his briefcase, when she opens his briefcase, every cloth that she had packed was so tidy, that it was exactly the way as she had packed. So she asked, how did you, because he was not a person of, he was not washing his clothes, he was not ironing. So it was a huge surprise for his wife. So she asked. So he remembered for a couple of days, where did I do? Did I give it to my laundry there in the hotel where I stayed? After 2 days, he realized he forgot to take that briefcase along with him. He had left the briefcase in the home. So he was so engrossed in the kind of work, in the kind of preparations that he was doing for his, you know, conference. So that is why people have achieved. And that is why we still remember him. Time immemorial will always remember Isaac Newton for what he did. We don't remember for what we are. So this small story, I think one should really keep it in mind. Hard work is the only way that we can achieve, with sympathy, with empathy, with love and gratitude, we will be defined in this society. I really acknowledge to have invited me to address to the wonderful students, to the meritorious students on the graduation day. I appreciate and I again congratulate and thank for the opportunity. Jai Hind, Jai Karnataka.
Thank you so much, sir, for taking time out of your busy schedule and gracing the occasion. Your words are a definite motivation to all of us today, and it is an honor to have heard you today. I now request Sri M.K. Shankarlinge Gowda, sir, Administrator, Raja Vukkaligra Sangha, to share his thoughts with us on this memorable day.
Respected Chief Guest, the Honorable Minister Dr. Sudhakar, Minister for Health and Medical Education, my colleagues, young friends. Dr. Sudhakar has covered a gamut of activities that the doctors should be involved in, and also the kind of dedication that they should have in their prospective career. And therefore, after him, I thought that I would make only 2-3 points and not more. First of all, let me congratulate you, the graduating UG and PG. I wish you the very best in your career. The graduates will be hoping for PG. The PGs will be hoping for super specialization. And these doctors, as we can see, never stop pursuing their higher education for a long period. And it is for the good of the country. I must compliment you for pursuing education and career. When I said pursuing education and career, I am reminded of the time that we had in this COVID period. Most of the work was done by PGs in KIMS. I should compliment the PGs for doing such a wonderful work. I used to be updated about the PGs falling ill, recovering, and then coming back to duty. The principal, Dr. Venkatesh, used to update me on that. I was really impressed by the dedication and also probably pressure from your seniors as well. But to come back to the work, I had only 2 cases in the whole period of the doctors not willing to come back and trying to put some pressure to escape the duty. Only just 2 cases. The rest were dedicated to the work that they were doing. I must compliment you for doing that work, and the kudos to you. Remember, this COVID has put a big focus on the medical field. Very big focus on the medical, the health sector. You know Dr. Guleria? Who is he? All right. Who is the health secretary? Nobody knows. Both of them appear in the press meet every week, every 15 days. Well, all of us know Dr. Guleria. A bureaucrat also sits with him. His name is Bhushan. You know, I am a bureaucrat, therefore I remember him. Nobody notices him. Dr. Guleria is known. Some specialists who speak about the mutation, the medicine, vaccination, etc. are remembered for the simple reason that this critical time has shown in a brighter, positive light the health sector. Take a cue from this. For the young graduates, I am saying, take a cue from this. You will be in limelight in the days to come. You will be in the need, you will be the need of the sector in the days to come. Therefore, use this opportunity. Try to specialize, become somebody, who can be made use of in this sector. We try to improve certain things in the KIMS in this small period. By adding, Dr. Sudhakar knows, he came personally to see the oxygen, shortage that happened in our hospital. Nothing happened, but the publicity in the press was so much, Everybody thought that the people from KIMS are going to be distributed all over, Bangalore. Nothing of that sort happened. There was some shortage of oxygen. Then we realized that we should not depend on a single source. We have added now the facility today of 13,000 liters of oxygen. We have put it in the front of the hospital, you would have noticed. Generally, these oxygen plants are kept away from the eyes of the people. But in our hospital, it is in the front of the hospital. We assure you that anytime you come to our hospital, right, you will go back recovered. There will be no shortage of oxygen. There is a temple in front of the hospital and there is oxygen. So, you depend on both of this, you will go back. That is the kind of assurance we would like to give to the people. We also have an excellent lab which was inaugurated by the minister today. We would like that lab to become a center of excellence. There should be, the minister was mentioning that there should be this gene sequencing, etc., activities, genomics should be pursued. It's an opportunity for the people who work in the KIMS to take that as a challenge and make this institution a center of excellence. In addition to providing facilities to the, patients, we should become a center of excellence. We have added paramedical course this year. It was not there for a long period. Paramedical course has been sanctioned by the government. We are grateful to the government for that. We have also done some improvement in physiotherapy, nursing, pharmacy, etc. But these are the services which will improve the quality of the healthcare that we provide in KIMS. In the days to come, this medical college and this hospital should become premier institutions in the state. They should become premier institution in the state. You know, Karnataka has a history, the minister was highlighting, Karnataka has a history of private engineering education, private medical education. The first engineering college in Asia, BMS Engineering College, was started in Bangalore. And then, early private medical college, Kasturba Medical College, was started in Karnataka. We have the tradition of starting these services in the private sector. KIMS has followed the same tradition. From 1980, we have been growing and we have added certain facilities. Now we have a huge student base. Those who pass out this year and the years to come, I wish them the very best. The faculty, they have done a very good job. The rank holders, I congratulate them. Look at the challenge that you have in the field, nationally and internationally, and be somebody. Challenge is to be somebody. You can be doctors everywhere. You see, there are certain doctors who are known in the interior part. People can recognize them just like that. He is Dr. So-and-so. There are so many fellows, DCs come, SPs come, and so many bureaucrats come. But that doctor is recognized. Why? It's the service that you render. So, society recognizes you as a special person. Don't lose that. Be somebody. My advice is, be somebody in the society and make an impact on the society. Being a doctor, you have an excellent opportunity to do so, and I am sure you will do that. All the best. Have a good day.
Thank you for those lovely words, sir. We now request the dignitaries on the dais to felicitate our chief guest. you, everyone. In the words of Oprah Winfrey, be thankful for what you have, you'll end up having more. If you concentrate on what you don't have, you'll never have enough.
A word of appreciation and deep sense of gratitude have crossed borders of civilization, philosophy, culture since time immemorial. I hope the new graduates will appreciate with sincere gratitude the efforts put forth by the numerous professors and supporting staff who have helped you in this journey and in making it a truly memorable one.
I now request Dr. Nivedita S.R. Ma'am, the principal of KIMS Paramedical College and our beloved professor of pathology, to deliver the word of thanks.
Thank you, Nishant. Respected dignitaries on the dais, my beloved students, all the proud parents who are there in the balcony and who have joined us online. I am fortunate enough to be given this opportunity to propose a vote of thanks every year. Indeed, it's a great pleasure. At the outset, heartiest congratulations to all my lovely graduating students. In this crazy corona year, it was a breath of fresh air to see you all so immaculately dressed and with so much of dreams in your eyes, looking so confident. My heart swells with pride to see you, especially the undergraduates, metamorphose from the shy teenagers to the confident doctors you are all today. You'll always be remembered as the Corona batch. I would love to call you all the crazy kids of Corona. First of all, on behalf of the management, faculty and the students of KIMS, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to the Honorable Minister, Dr. K. Sudhakar. Your excellent oration graduation address has definitely given some inspiring words to our graduates. Thank you for reinforcing empathy and sympathy as the main mottos of medical profession, and also to reinforce that doctors are eternal learners. I think the entire management of KIMS and all of us, thank you for appreciating the efforts of KIMS in battling COVID-19. Thank you, sir. Inspiring words from a young, dynamic leader like you, from our own fraternity, is definitely the crown of today's graduation day celebration. In your dream of modernizing PHCs, we and our graduates are definitely going to contribute. Thank you very much, sir, for gracing this august occasion. A grand occasion like this is not possible without the able support and guidance from the management. We are very grateful to our patrons, Sri M.K. Shankar Lingegowda, Administrator Rajya Okkaligara Sangha, and Sri S. Shankar Narayan, CEO Rajya Okkaligara Sangha, for their unstinted support and guidance. They have been extremely proactive in improving the existing measures. Being from the Department of Pathology, sir was mentioning that the lab should become a center of excellence. We would definitely thrive to make it a center of excellence. Thank you both for your excellent guidance and support. Our beloved Dean and Principal, Dr. V.T. Venkatesha, despite battling the corona blues, juggling the administration, still gave a patient ear to wish of the students to hold the graduation day ceremony this year amidst the corona pandemic. Thank you, sir. I'm sure all the graduates will always cherish and remember this gesture of yours. And his excellent support in all the organization will always be appreciated and remembered. Corona duty rosters, statistics to the government, facing the media, our hospital administrators, RMS, Dr. Ashwath Narayan, and AMO, Dr. Murli, have been battling all the blues. They have been excellent in supporting the today's graduation day ceremony. Our apologies to all the parents and family members for the restriction. Thank you is a small word for the excellent cooperation that all of you have given. I would request all the graduating students to give a loud round of applause to all the parents without whose support
I'm sure all of us realize they are the wind beneath all our wings. Thank you, parents. Dr. Nandini, our academic registrar, has been the key in the seemingly smooth grand graduation day today. Thank you, Dr. Nandini, for battling all our doubts and being always there for our support. I take this opportunity to thank Dr. Vasant Kumar and Dr. Adarsh, who have accepted our invitation and to be here for this graduation day ceremony. Especially Dr. Vasant Kumar, who has contributed immensely to KIMS in various capacities and also to Rajiv Gandhi University. Thank you, sir. This is what KIMS epitomizes: service always with a heart. Satata seva tatparate. Can we hear it for all the volunteers? Thank you, volunteers. This is the first time postgraduates have been actively involved in looking after with the organization, and looking at their excitement and excellence, this trend is going to continue. Thank you even to the postgraduate volunteers. You all saw the smooth trail of events, the certificates coming online, the trophies coming online, and I'm sure this will not happen offbeat. Thank you to Dr. Priya, Dr. Sujaya, and Dr. Shubha for their excellent organizational skills. We also thank Sri Chaudeshwar Rao for the colorful gowns all of you are wearing, Swami Florist for the grand decoration, Panchamukhi Arts for the beautiful mementos. Memorable pics are always a treasure. Thanks to our dear photographers, Mr. Shekhar, Ramesh, and Venugopal, for capturing the moments. Thank you, Mr. Devu, for the excellent arrangements for the lunch, and MS Caterers has laid down a sumptuous meal downstairs. Thank you, Mr. Shekhar. I end by wishing you all the best for everything in your life. May the best things happen to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Goodbyes are not forever. Goodbyes are not the end. Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened. No matter where life leads you, no matter what you do, we'll always be your biggest fans, and we'll be here for you.
On that note, we have arrived at the last leg of today's ceremony, and what better way to end the same than by paying a tribute to our own motherland. I request everyone to stand up for the instrumental national anthem played by our students. Thank you. Kindly take your seats.
Hearty congratulations to our graduates, and thank you all for your patience through the entire ceremony. Please do join us for the graduation day lunch arranged in the basement. All the undergraduate students, you're requested to please stay back for a few more minutes. All the others can leave.